Greetings. I want to encourage you, brother, to always be ready. 2 Timothy 2:15. Study to show yourself approved unto God, a workman that needs not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. 1 Peter 3:15. But sanctify Christ as Lord in your hearts, always being ready to make a defense to anyone who asks you to give an account for the hope that is in you, yet with gentleness and reverence. You may think you will have time to prepare, that you will be warned of the test, that you can schedule your defense. But what if this happened to you? Acts 8:26. And the angel of the Lord spake unto Philip, saying, Arise, and go toward the south unto the way that goes down from Jerusalem unto Gaza, which is desert. And he arose and went, and beheld a man of Ethiopia, a eunuch of great authority under Candace, queen of the Ethiopians, who had the charge of all her treasures, and had come to Jerusalem for to worship, was returning and sitting in his chariot, read Esaias the prophet. Then the Spirit said unto Philip, Go near and join thyself to this chariot. This is most likely the same angel, because the Greek does not contain hagion, meaning holy, which we would find in reference to the Holy Spirit. Also, the Greek used in 8:26 is angelos, and not even pneuma. Acts 8:30, And Peter ran thither to him, and heard him read the prophet Esaias, and said, Understandest thou what thou readest? Yo, G, you understand what you're reading? And he said, How can I, except some man should guide me? And he desired Philip that he would come up and sit with him. The place of the scripture which he read was this: He was led as a sheep to the slaughter, and like a lamb dumb before his shearer, so opened he not his mouth. Do you know what he was reading? It says he was reading Esaias, which means Isaiah, specifically Isaiah 53, verse 7. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearers is dumb, so he opened not his mouth. He was reading this. In his humiliation his judgment was taken away, and who shall declare his generation? For his life is taken from the earth. And the eunuch answered Philip and said, I pray thee, of whom speaketh the prophet this? Of himself or of some other man? He asked, Who is prophet Isaiah talking about? Then Philip opened his mouth and began at the same scripture and preached unto him Jesus. Philip preached this verse meant Jesus. In fact, most of Isaiah 53 talks specifically, prophetically, about Jesus. Was Philip ready? You betcha. But he had help. Luke 24:27. Then beginning with Moses and with all the prophets, he, meaning Jesus, explained to them the things concerning himself in all the scriptures. Now this particular teaching session was on a road, but I'm confident the teaching got around. Based on what? Well, based on the fact this account of this incident made it. I can hear it now. So Jesus appeared to you? What did he say? I'm thinking it's either that question or, did he have an Obama sticker on his ass? I mean donkey? Surely it must have been one of those two possible questions. I think, brother, in 30 years of attending church, I've never heard a sermon on Isaiah 53. Just an occasional verse or phrase every now and then. It is a prophetic chapter describing the servant of God, the Messiah. Isaiah 53:1, Who hath believed our report, and to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of a dry ground. He hath no form nor comeliness, and when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. Comeliness means attractiveness. There is no beauty that we should desire him. We will not be drawn to some handsome figure. Some speculate that he retains the damage caused during his torture and sufferings. Isaiah 53:3, he is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. Pay attention to the substitutionary wording. He has borne our griefs. He carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. Within Judaism, some rabbis teach that the suffering servant is the nation of Israel. But reread this verse and see if there is any way this could be a nation. Ignore for the moment the masculine personal pronoun, he. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes we are healed. If he is the nation of Israel, who is the we? With his stripes we are healed. It would have to be non-Israelites, if he is the nation of Israel. I just don't see Isaiah speaking from the Gentile voice position very often, if ever. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Phrase after phrase, dogpiling the fact, he would take our place. God puts our iniquity on him. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearers is dumb, so he opened not his mouth. And this was the verse the Ethiopian Jew was reading. Philip was ready and preached this verse meant Jesus. So we can trust that this is a prophecy about Jesus. He was taken from prison and from judgment, and who shall declare his generation? For he was cut off out of the land of the living. For the transgression of my people was he stricken. Cut off means killed. Think about Daniel 9:26. And after 62 weeks shall Messiah be cut off, but not for himself. But not for himself. I'm sure mention of being cut off is not unique, but it mostly happens as a consequence, judgment, or punishment. Genesis 17:14, and the uncircumcised male who is not circumcised in the flesh of his foreskin, that soul shall be cut off from his people. He hath broken my covenant. Exodus 12:19, 7 days shall there be no leaven found in your houses. For whosoever eats that which is leavened, that soul shall be cut off from the congregation of Israel, whether he be a sojourner or one that is born in the land. Isaiah 9:14, therefore the Lord will cut off from Israel head and tail, branch and rush in one day. The ancient and honorable, meaning elder, he is the head, and the prophet that teaches lies, he is the tail. Mostly it happens as a consequence, judgment, or punishment, but not for someone else's transgressions. For the transgression of my people was he stricken. Again, if he is the nation of Israel, who are my people? And he made his grave with the wicked and with the rich in his death, because he had done no violence, neither was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him, he hath put him to grief. When thou shalt make his soul an offering for sin. That's another phrase with a ring of familiarity. 2 Corinthians 5:21. He made him who knew no sin to be sin on our behalf, so that we might become the righteousness of God in him. When thou shalt make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed, he shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. He shall see the travail of his soul, and shall be satisfied. By his knowledge shall my righteous servant justify many, for he shall bear their iniquities. He will justify many, because he bears their iniquities. Brother, do not listen when Islam lies that Jesus did not die. Do not listen to the lie that no one can take another's punishment. Therefore will I divide him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he has poured out his soul unto death. Brother, do not listen to the lie Islam tells that Jesus did not die. Jesus poured out his soul unto death. And do not believe any man who says different. And he was numbered with the transgressors, and he bare the sin of many, and made intercession for the transgressors. I have only briefly mentioned some of the many prophecies fulfilled from Isaiah 53. But make no mistake, it refers to Jesus, Yeshua. Read and study the Old Testament prophecies of Messiah. Know them. And know they are the more sure word of prophecy that Peter spoke of. 2 Peter 1:19. We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto you do well that you take heed, as unto a light that shines in a dark place, until the day dawn and the day star arise in your hearts. The prophecies of the suffering servant were fulfilled the first time Yeshua came. Jesus' identity is confirmed, no, proven by the fulfillments. I believe he's coming soon. And when he comes again, it will be as the lion of the tribe of Judah. And he's not going to negotiate with Satan or Islam. Revelation 19:20. And the beast was taken, and with him the false prophet that wrought miracles before him, with which he deceived them that had received the mark of the beast, and them that worshipped his image. These both were cast alive into a lake of fire burning with brimstone. And the remnant, the rest, all of those with them, were slain with the sword of him that sat upon the horse, which sword proceeded out of his mouth, and all the fowls were filled with their flesh. Christians, do not rejoice at the destruction of the wicked. Instead, rejoice that your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Christians, hold fast to the confession of your faith. Do not deny the Son of God, and be ready to explain why you believe in him. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.